In continuation to our yoga for back pain, we have few supine or lying down asanas also.
Namaste, I am Priyanka and I welcome you to HDFC Ergo's Health for Happiness session on yoga for back pain. Specific yoga sequences can help to gradually open and strengthen the muscles around your lower back and hips.
Let's start Anand Balasana. Lie on your back, knees bent, and now bring the knees close to your chest. Inhale, and as you exhale, hold the toes with your hands from inside and press the knee and thigh close to your chest, putting pressure on the lower back. This pose, with its stretch at the inner thighs and lower hip, will tighten the muscle, thus giving the lower back a good support. Remain here for about 6 breaths or as per your comfort. If 6 breaths is difficult, then release from the pose and relax, and go into the pose again. Pavan Muktasana. From happy baby pose, bring the knees together with the feet off the floor and press them close to your tummy and chest. With exhalation, press the thigh close to the upper and lower abdomen. Bring the hands around the knee and press it close to your chest. Stay here for a few seconds. Then keep your hands on the mid shin bone and then ankle, pressing the whole back in the process. Remain for around 6 breaths in each position, pushing the tummy with every exhalation. The unwanted gas in our abdomen area also causes stiffness in the lower back and hip. Therefore, this asana helps to release the gas and strengthens your lower back. Supta Parivetra Garudasana. Release from Pavan Muktasana and stretch the legs out and relax the entire back and body. After taking few breaths here, bring your left leg up, bending at the knee, and place it over the right leg, interlocking the left ankle behind the right calf. Exhale, drop the left knee on the right side and take a few breaths here by holding on to the left knee with your right hand and look towards the left, turning your head. Ensure the hip is not turning up too much towards the right and remain close to the floor. And slowly exhale and come back in center. Repeat this with the right leg over the left leg. Remain here for 6 breaths, feeling the stretch at the right lower back and hip. Ardha Halasana. Now take a breath and as you exhale, bring the legs at 90 degrees, ensuring the entire back is on the floor and with the pressure at the abdominal muscle. Stay in this pose for 6 breaths. This pose works on the lower back directly, and so if it is hard for the back, then one can avoid this. Else one can stay for few breaths and repeat it again after releasing the pose. Setu Bandhasana. Stay on your back with legs bent at the knee and remain for a few breaths here. Inhale, and as you exhale, raise the entire lower back upwards, including the upper back and the thighs off the floor. Exhale completely and balance the body on your shoulders, head and feet on the floor. You could use your arms and wrists to support your hip and bring the stretch deeper, moving upwards, raising the pelvis and the chest upwards. Get into the normal breathing if comfortable and stay there for 6 breaths or as per your comfort. Now release gently with every exhalation, bringing the upper back on the floor and slowly placing the lower back down completely. Now relax your neck and shoulder. Bring the body flat on the floor with knees bent and relax in Shavasana.
These yoga postures are helpful in strengthening the back and maintaining a general health of the spine. If you have a serious back issues like slip disc or arthritis, we strongly recommend that you consult your doctors before trying out any of these yoga postures. Pregnant women should consult a doctor before doing these yoga asanas. Most women accept back pain as a common symptoms of pregnancy, but it is important to attend to it so that your back doesn't trouble you after delivery. Thank you for joining me in HDFC Ergo's Health for Happiness session.